Do you remember when you had a device and it just played music? There was no like Facebook notifications, no calls, no like pop-ups, and it was just, it was music. It was your music. You had it. It could never go away. And yeah, it's time to get an MP3 player again, honestly. It's really good for your mental health. Like, you can be like this guy. You can be like this guy. Yeah? Just smile. You can be like these people. Happy. Nah, but really, you should get one. If you want a little demo of mine here, it's this the Sansa C 240 or 50. Either way, 128 gigabyte SD card thrown in it, format FAT32, and it's really solid. Like, I use like the little file browser to look for music because it's just easier. It has a little light up thingy. Has the Japanese cell phone strap. Like, that's nice. You can add that. And also, unrelated, you should get that Velcro stuff for everything, for all your cords, because it's wild out there. You gotta have your cords wrangled. But yeah, and best choice is just gonna be Sansa with Rockbox. Like, don't even consider any of these others. Like, any other MP3 player, any newer one, just stick to the Sansas. Like, get some nice themes here. Here are themes for the C200 series. And if we pop on eBay, yeah, it's not too bad. Probably find them a little bit cheaper some places, but honestly, yeah, just pick one up. And then we got the little bit fancier E200 series. It's a little like iPod like wheel to scroll through music, and you can just search like, you know, 280 or 270 or just any of the 200 series, and it should all be compatible. And yeah, they all take like SD cards. The C series has like a removable battery with batteries you can never find anywhere, but still, I appreciate the effort. And yeah, we got a few. We got the clip zip on here too. And that one's, it's kind of all over the place price point wise. Should also take the SD card. Just don't confuse this with the sport, because that one is not supported. And if you want to know what is supported, you can go over right over here to their device status page, and it's got like a nice little list here. And so, yeah, it's probably your best experience. You can just get the little Rockbox utility. They have one for all major operating systems. It's pretty nice. It's open source. They have a little guides on unbreaking your devices, but we'll get back to that. And yeah, SD cards are like, they're dirt cheap. Like, 12 bucks for 120 gigabytes is like, it's crazy. Only thing is, you're going to have to format it in FAT32, which normally only goes up to 32 gigabytes. So you're going to need to use this program, FAT32 Format, to format that to FAT32 if it's over that. So you can have like the, you know, a few hundred gigs of music or something like that. And then gonna want to pair it with these Koss Porta Pro headphones. Like, they just can't be beat price wise, portability wise, repairability. It's great. There's a little band you can expand. There's two like little earphone things that you can replace too. The drivers. And yeah, I like to add like a little band to mine, just so it's not like scraping on my scalp, and adds a little bit of flair to it too. It's kind of nice, like, oh, it's all cozy. And then yeah, these little Yaxi Earpads, which are they're honestly pretty good. Like, they're really like soft to wear, It's like not wearing anything almost. So yeah, and then the best part about it is you can just fold it all up easily and just throw it into your pocket. If you have like dude pockets, you can do it. If you have dude pockets, like this is, oh man, it's the most, these are the most portable over the ear headphones you're gonna get. It doesn't get better than that. And yeah, $40, I mean, you could pay that much or you can wait till Prime Day, where it's like usually like 25 or 30. And then yeah, you're gonna want to get the little fabric thing for the band, the Yaxi pads for the ears, and then yeah, these little Velcro things, they go a long way. You can wrap up all your cords. It's super convenient. And yeah, this guy right here has a really good guide too, if you want to go a little bit further than I did. If you want the MMCX sockets for your Porta Pro, this guy's like a nice little guide on it. It's, oh man, it's really helpful. You can also go on like AliExpress, and they have everything from replacement bands to replacement drivers to ones that already have the MMCX like sockets on them, already have the cords. Like, it's pretty helpful. Like, eBay has a few of those too. Like, if you just search for the Porta Pro and then MMCX, you got little kits and ship pretty quick. So yeah, it's all pretty nice headphones. I mean, good for earbuds if you really want the 2000s look. And then yeah, you're gonna need some music for it, so a couple ways you can go. You just start downloading MP3s, I guess, you know, from your video games and the Kingdom Hearts Insider, like it's like 2005. And then yeah, you can go grab some old Henry Rollins shows. He has some cool music. That's still a thing. You can go to WFMU site where they still have like that MP3 section that they never use, which, I don't know, that's just what you used to do back in the day. You shared the MP3s, you ripped your records, like, be like, oh yeah, here's an MP3 of my A side, and here's an MP3 of my B side. And, oh, there it is! A side, oh, no, it didn't have the split one, but it's one of these on here. Gonna be split. Oh, there's side one, side two. Some guy just like hooked up his turntable to his whole Audacity, and he's like, oh yeah, I'm gonna record this, just put it up here with all the other hipster stuff. And it was, yeah, it was a good time to be a hipster. Or you want to get your Jpop with the site that consistently gets taken down. So, or you know, the Soulseek. As long as you're sharing music back, I mean, Soulseek is decent, but a time sink. And then there's the lazy person's method. You go over to yt-dlp's GitHub page. Scroll down here. You scroll down too far to the install section. And there we go. If you're in Windows, and you probably are, you're just going to get this portable executable file. Then you're going to want to go over to ffmpeg, one of someone like just distributing like binaries. And you're going to want to just get, yeah, just this one here. We'll say this one here. Really just need the little executable. And you can go and you can throw them in. It's like a folder right there, just so you can call them. Then copy that little directory there. Bring up your command prompt. It's getting there. It's trying. Oh no. Technical difficulties. But anyway, your CD over there, right into music, where it has those two portable executables, and then there's this nice site, cheat.sh, and they have a bunch of neat little cheat sheets for extensible terminal applications. And got a little modified one here where it's just gonna do extract audio, but instead of MP3, it's gonna do Opus. Now, Opus, if you're downloading anything new, just use that. As far as like a lossy container, it's really good. Like, you're not gonna hear the difference between that and MP3. And yeah, you just paste that right into the command prompt in the right directory. And it should try to call those. I'm gonna try to make a new file on here. Let me control C. Nope, shouldn't have controlled C. It's starting to download. Control C when you're in like a command prompt, just it usually cancels stuff out. You gotta like spam it a little bit, but I guess I didn't spam it, so that works. But yeah, just get your MP3 player, get you good headphones, get you good music, and then get the fuck away from your phone. Like, you're on that shit all the time. Just grab your music, grab your little Mark Barron podcast, and yeah, get away from it.